In the world of Dark Souls, the age of humanity was falling. Supernatural creatures and monsters of all sorts of shape and size roamed the lands. The heroes are gone, and there is no hope that the world will continue on.
Sounds like Pokemon. Only without the whole humanity falling apart thing.
Well, unlike Pokemon, there's more darker shit going on. Along with an undead curse falling upon others, turning anyone with a mysterious dark sign into dark hollows upon many painful deaths.
Sheesh. Well, I'm glad I'm not immortal.
However, there is a prophecy of a chosen undead who would journey to the home of the gods and save the world once and for all. And this prophecy will come true thanks to a knight saving someone from an abandoned asylum along with a huge-ass raven, which started the journey of this chosen undead. And the chosen undead will bring a lot of weapons and abilities to combat the horrors that lies ahead. And the chosen undead has the immortality to get through. You can stab an undead, eat them, or even tear out their souls. They will still be living since undead don't need their souls to live. And once they die, they can resurrect to the nearest bonfire. And they have the weapons to boot, like daggers and such. And they also have weapons of the bosses they defeated to gain them, or even killing other heroes, which is how they were able to get Goth's great bow, which can shoot arrows large enough to one-shot a dragon. But what makes the chosen undead a great combatant is his many swords. No knight or undead can't ever go walking without one.
Makes me ponder, what if we're all just a simulation? What if we're actually immortal but are too afraid to try any of that? What if we're fictional characters?
Oh, come on, Mav. That's crazy. This is totally not a simulation. Wait, is it? Oh, God. Now I'm thinking about it. Somebody help! Ugh. I don't want to ever think about something like that again.
Yeah, you just tried kissing a cactus over that.
Never again. Well, after we recover from that horrible thinking, come back to Wacky Debates next time as we cover the Chosen Undead's opponent, Scooby-Doo.